That's how social collapse starts. And then we've got the food, haven't we? What happens when we run out of food? I think like last year, there was no courgettes in the shops in February. Does anyone remember that? And everyone's having a little bit of a joke, right? I didn't think it was funny. Because I grow food and I know what it means. I know what it means when there's snowstorms in southern Spain. It means something's coming down the line. And what came down the line happened last year. For the first time, there were food growing crises across the Northern Hemisphere. 20% down in North America, Europe and Russia, all in 1 year. And as a sustainability professor, 30 years in the trade, he said, if that happens 3 years running, there'll be mass starvation in Europe. In 3 years. He's written a paper about it. It's been downloaded 450,000 times. The most downloaded academic paper in history. Why? Because people have been fed up about being lied to. Everyone start to wake up and want to know what's actually going on. About 15 years ago, I planted out all my crops, 20 acres of crops, started raining on the 2nd of June. It rained every day for 7 weeks. I lost every single outdoor vegetable. I lost £100,000, 20 people lost their jobs. I was out of my head with stress, but no one cares, right? Who cares? Because if you can't get your food from West Wales, you can fly it in. And then the following year, rained almost for 7 weeks again. And then we had the warmest April. Then we had the dullest August. Then we had the coldest winter on record. Minus 15 for a fortnight. I lost 30,000 leeks. Every single leek. And then last year, it was the warmest summer on record in Wales. But it didn't matter. Do you know why it didn't matter? Because I don't grow food anymore. I don't grow food outside. Because I can't afford it. I can't afford the risk. There used to be 20 horticulturalists in West Wales. Now there's 4. I spoke to one of my mates. He said, I'm packing up. It'd be better for me to go to Swansea Casino and put my 40 grand down. Because he doesn't know what's going to happen. And there's literally hundreds of millions of farmers around the world shitting themselves every year now because they don't know what's going to happen. And if you grow food for a living, the worst thing is not knowing what's going to happen because you don't know what to do. It's a casino, right? So we knew this like 10, 15 years ago. So that's the food. But the real end point here is war. Because what do you think is going to happen when hundreds of millions of refugees are fleeing from the tropics? There's going to be war. And we haven't had war here since the 1940s. Not a big war, but it's coming back. So my suggestion to you is, when you're talking to the good people of Penzance and West Cornwall, don't talk about the polar bears, right? talk about social collapse. Talk about the welfare payments. Talk about the food in Tesco's not being there. And talk about their kids being sent off to be slaughtered. Because that's what the climate crisis means. Long before London and the global cities are flooded with water, which is now locked in.